This video explains how you can run the Selenium test in PHP on local Mac machine. So for that, you need to have PHP installed on your system. It's out of scope of this video to show you how to install the PHP. I'm assuming that you have got PHP installed on your system already. Next thing that you need to do is you need to execute this command curl get composer installer. So this command is going to install the composer. Composer is a package manager for PHP projects. After that, you can think of Composer as npm in case of Node.js. So it does the same thing, like gets the packages and installs in your local system. After Composer is installed, you can download and install the packages. For example, to execute Selenium tests, we will need a PHP web driver. And to have the unit testing framework, you will need this PHP unit package. So you can install that using these commands. You can also use directly Composer if it is in your path. Once these dependencies or the packages are installed, it's very easy to get started with the Selenium automation. All you have to do is just write the test case as shown here. Remember that all these packages classes are in this namespace Facebook Web Driver Remote, and you need to, just like how you use using an import in C Sharp and Java, same way if you want to use some classes in certain package or namespace, you need to use this syntax. Use and then class name or the package name. And then over here, what we have done is we are using PHP unit 9, that is version 9 of this unit testing framework. And there are two methods, setup and teardown. In the setup method, what we are doing is we are giving the Chrome driver path and then executing the test on Chrome. In teardown, we are quitting the browser. In test title, this method, we are just checking that the title of this website is contains the software model. It's very simple test basically. And also note that when you execute this PHP composer require commands, composer.json file is created where it will store all the dependencies required for the project. For example, if you install these two dependencies, this will be added into composer.json. Now to execute the tests, what you have to do is you have to use this command called as php init and then your file name. I'm just gonna show you how to execute this now. So this is the command php init browser test dot php file over test residing, and then you have to give the report path as well. So as you can see, Chrome browser was launched and test is executed. Remember that you can't start the Safari driver like that. There is no class like Safari driver in PHP implementation of Selenium. What you have to do is you have to use the Selenium standalone server, and through that server it will communicate with the Safari browser. And also note that we have used this at the end, this flag log JUnit. So what we are telling is create the test report in this JUnit format and store it in this file. So you can see this report is created in here. And just to give you example of the Safari, here you can see in the Safari we are launching this standalone Selenium server which is running on this default URL. And then you can create the driver like that. So remember that you will have to start the standalone server, otherwise this program will not work. Then for Firefox, you can use the same syntax, and additionally you can also start the Qco driver as well. So basically this is the command that you need to execute when you are starting the standalone server. So this is the standalone Selenium server, and remember that we are passing this Chrome driver and the Qco driver paths, otherwise standalone server will not know like which where the binaries are available for the Firefox automation and Chrome automation, because for Firefox automation you need a Gecko driver, and for Chrome automation you need Chrome driver, but for Safari you don't need any driver, so you can directly execute that program in Safari's case. So I think that's it in this video. If you have more questions on this, let me know through the comments. And also in the next video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to push this repository to Azure DevOps and execute tests on Azure directly. Thanks for watching this video.